you guys know sunscreen is one of the most important steps of your skincare routine, and I'm constantly trying new ones, so I wanted to give you an updated favorite sunscreens video. Have a couple of videos on sunscreens that I really enjoy. One of the sunscreens I really loved was from a brand called Purito, and that sunscreen has since been removed from the market. And I know that this topic is starting to come up a little bit lately, so I decided, you know what, let's do a little refresh, try out some new sunscreens, share some that I've been loving lately. There are so many different sunscreens on the market. I feel like, you know, there's bound to be something that you're going to love. All right, so first up is this one from Elta MD. This is the UV Restore Broad Spectrum SPF 40. I love this sunscreen. I put it in my 2020 favorites because I started using this sometime like last fall, and I just can't get enough of it. I think this is one of the best mineral sunscreens that I personally have ever used. It has squalane in it. It has THD ascorbate in it, which is a derivative of vitamin C. Those two things together make it feel like it's a little bit more like skincare to me, in the sense of like the squalane really helps to moisturize your skin and balance it, especially if you do have dry skin. For anybody that's wearing like a mask all day and you feel like you're getting a lot of like chafing and chapped skin from that mask, this is a really wonderful sunscreen for that because of the squalane that it has in it. It's just very rich and moisturizing for the skin. I love that it has THD ascorbate in it too. It's not really in there to be like that brightening vitamin C for your skin, though you might get some of those benefits from it. What I like about having vitamin C in my sunscreen is that it's an antioxidant, it's a very powerful one, and we know that when you pair vitamin C with sunscreen, they work hand in hand to really protect your skin. The vitamin C protects you against the free radicals, and the sunscreen protects you against the UV damage that you might be getting from your skin, so you're just getting an all-in-one, really great sunscreen. It's also all mineral sunscreen, and I tend to not love mineral sunscreens usually, not when they're 100% mineral sunscreen. I prefer, for the most part, the hybrid sunscreens or the chemical sunscreens, and that's just because I think they look better on the skin, just in general, for different skin tones, for, you know, just the feel of it, if you're gonna wear them underneath your makeup. There are just so many reasons why I prefer hybrid or chemical sunscreens usually, but this one kind of changed the game for me. This one looks and feels so nice on the skin. This does have a tint to it, but you can get an untinted one as well. For my skin tone and for a couple of people that I've had try it that have a slightly darker skin tone than I do, this looks great. But I did have a couple of friends that tried it out that have darker skin tones than me say that they definitely could not wear this on a regular basis. All right, so the next one is this by Shiseido. It is the Urban Environment Oil-Free UV Protector. This is broad spectrum. It is SPF 42. It's a hybrid sunscreen, meaning that it has both chemical filters and it has mineral filters in it. The reason why I like a hybrid sunscreen, because I find myself actually, you know, liking the hybrid sunscreens the most. The reason why you would want a hybrid like that is because you get a little bit more broad spectrum protection because you are getting the benefit of the chemical filter and the mineral filters, but also chemical filters just happen to be a little bit more cosmetically elegant. So if you want a sunscreen that feels nicer on the skin, that doesn't feel so thick, and if you want it to be maybe like an oil-free sunscreen like this that, you know, leaves more of like a matte finish on your skin, then you're probably going to get better results if you get something that is a chemical sunscreen or one that has a hybrid. So if you really want to find something that feels nice for your skin, kind of like the best of both worlds is getting a hybrid sunscreen like this one. I really wanted to point this one out because it is oil-free and it does have that matte finish to it. A lot of people, you know, point out to me that I use a lot of dewy sunscreens and my face ends up looking, you know, in some people's opinions, my skin looks like it's greasy, which I think is great. I'm like all about having disco ball face these days, but I get that a lot of people don't want to have that look also. And some people have oily skin or normal skin and they just don't feel like they want to add more of that like dewiness and that shine to their skin. So I get it. This doesn't do that. This has more of like a serum-like texture to it. It's very light. It's very milky when you put it onto your skin and it dries down really matte. It has kind of like a powder finish to it. It actually has oil absorbing powder in it. There's peony root and both of those work together to just help with that excess shine and that excess oil. So it really is drying down to a matte finish. It does not not feel dry or cracky or anything like that. It just looks really smooth. I partnered up with Shiseido actually for an IGTV. After I put it on, I put foundation on over it as well to demonstrate how it looks, and it looks beautiful as a primer underneath your makeup. You get this really nice smooth finish to your foundation when you have this on, so it really is working like a primer. I think that's important to note because it does leave a little bit of a white cast to the skin, so it does, in my opinion, look better underneath your makeup. Another thing that I want to point out about this sunscreen is that it can be a little bit tricky because it is that matte finish, so you want to make sure you pat it into your skin and you're not using too many hydrating and moisturizing products. You know, I think that the person who would choose to use an oil-free sunscreen is most likely a person who's not packing on all of the hydrators and moisturizers the way I do. But for anybody that does use a lot of moisturizers or hydrators or a really thick moisturizer at the very least, make sure that you're patting this onto your skin so you don't get any pilling from it. All right, next up. Ta-da! The Fenty Hydravisor. This is their invisible moisturizer. I think there's this misconception that, and you know, I've even fallen for this like whole thing that, you know, moisturizers that have SPF are different than an SPF that is moisturizing, but really at the end of the day, they're the same thing. Like, this is an SPF that happens to be moisturizing, so they call it a moisturizer that has SPF. So basically, if you want to skip having a moisturizer and an SPF separately, you can use something like this. Or you can even use like that LTMD that I was just talking about that is very moisturizing. It leaves just enough of an occlusive layer for some skin types. I personally need a little bit more moisture underneath because I have dry skin. But for some people, that might be all that you need as far as a moisturizer goes. The thing that you want to keep in mind when you want to just like make it an all-in-one, you have to make sure you're covering everything. And I think sometimes when people are using a moisturizer, they feel like they're only going to put moisturizer where they need it, right? So like if you feel like you get oily in your T-zone, you might skip that area. So these are things to keep in mind when you're choosing something like this. So let's go ahead and talk about this though. This one is SPF 30, it's all chemical filters. This does have a fragrance to it. If you are sensitive to fragrance, obviously avoid it. You know, what's funny is when I first did a review of the Fenty Skin products, I kept being like, what is this fragrance? What is this? You know what it reminds me of? It smells like a Victoria's Secret fragrance to me. I can't tell you which one, but it's like reminiscent of like that kind of a scent, like one of those body sprays, you know, that you would put on from Victoria's Secret. So if you like to smell like that, I think it's a beautiful fragrance. So if you like a fragrance, then you're gonna love this one because it really is like a really pretty fragrance. It reminds me, like I said, of one of those like body sprays, you know, where you kind of smell like a little bit fruity and a little bit flirty. That's kind of what it smells like. This also has niacinamide in it. It has hyaluronic acid in it. So it's just an all around really nice sunscreen. It feels like it's a moisturizer because it has those ingredients to it also. The niacinamide is going to be great for anybody that wants to just, you know, protect and support their skin barrier, that want to see a little bit of like decreased oil production or balanced oil production. For anybody that wants that hydration, the hyaluronic acid is really nice in this. You get this like glow to your skin, but it's just enough of a glow. It's like a little bit of a dewiness to your skin, but it just looks healthy. So this is a beautiful sunscreen. It comes in a refillable package as well, which I think is really innovative and pretty. And I just think it's a nice sunscreen. And I know a lot of people, Anna from my team, for instance, loves this stuff. She buys this all the time. It's her go-to sunscreen and she's obsessed with it. And then the last one that I really enjoy is this one from Supergoop. This is their Daily Dose Vitamin C Plus SPF. This is an SPF 40. It is all chemical filters in this one also. Like I said, you guys, chemical filters tend to look better. They tend to feel better. They're more elegant to use on your skin. So it's no wonder that people end up enjoying and liking chemical filters more. You tend to find them in products like this that have more of like a skincare benefit to them. And I don't mean as a serum. I actually will address that in just a second because I think that's very confusing to people, but it does feel really nice. It has this nice light serum texture to it. It's not ultra dewy when you put it on your skin, so you're not gonna look like a disco ball if you don't want to, and it feels really light. That's really what I love about this. Like I said with the LTMD sunscreen, I really like when sunscreens have vitamin C built into it because we know it's a really great antioxidant. Paired with your sunscreen, it just makes it work even harder for you. So the vitamin C in this specifically is the 3-O-ethyl ascorbic acid. So it's a vitamin C derivative. It's a really nice one, one that I've really enjoyed in some of my other products as well. It also has Kakadu plum in here, which is also also rich in vitamins, it's nourishing for the skin, and it's also just full of antioxidants, which again, are great in a sunscreen. And then they also have 2% niacinamide in this, which is just a really good amount of niacinamide. If you don't wanna use a separate niacinamide serum, you're getting the benefits from it in this one. So that will help to give you a little bit more luminous skin, protect your skin barrier, balance your oil production. This is a really nicely formulated sunscreen. It feels very nice on the skin. Now, I know a couple of people have pointed out that in the instructions, they have said to use this as your serum step in your skincare routine, but I've also heard them say that you can use this as the last step in your skincare routine. So that's how I prefer that you use this. I'm not really sure if you can use it as a serum step in your skincare routine and then put a moisturizer on and go on and on and on, you know, with all of that kind of stuff. Maybe there's a little bit more to it, but I prefer that you use this as the last step in your skincare routine after your moisturizer. The brand says that you can do that as well with this. And I think it just feels like a nice light layer that you're putting on over your moisturizer. It's really nice. Next up is not one sunscreen, but two sunscreens, but one brand, and that is Unsun. The main difference that you'll see is that one of them is lightweight and matte, so it's gonna give you that matte finish to your skin if you're one of those people that don't like it to be dewy looking like I do, or if you have oily skin or something, you might prefer to use this one. And then they also have another one that's a little bit more of a dewy finish. I love the way it feels. I actually played with both of them and they have this really nice, almost like moisturizing feel to them. But like I said, this one is more of a matte finish to it. It's really pretty. Both of these are SPF 30. They are both full mineral sunscreens. That's one of the main reasons why I wanted to point this brand out to you, because I know that there are some other really great sunscreens that work for melanin-rich skin tones. I hear a lot of people say, well, what about like Black Girl sunscreen? Those are beautiful sunscreens that they have to offer, and I think that they're great, but I do see people asking about mineral sunscreens. So because of just like the nature of what mineral sunscreen is, it's really hard to find a mineral sunscreen that doesn't leave some kind of a white cast on your skin, or even maybe like a gray cast to the skin. The brand is vegan and cruelty-free, and also both of these are water-resistant, which I think is very important to point out as well. Water-resistant sunscreens will last on the skin a little bit longer, especially if you do sweat more or if you have, you know, oily skin or something. They tend to stay in place a little bit better. So these are both really nice sunscreens, but to demonstrate how they look on the skin, I decided to ask my friend Terrell Britton to test these out and share his thoughts. So here's what he said.
What is poppin', beautiful people? My name is Terrell Britton. I'm here with Mix Makeup, and I'm giving you my first reaction on the brand Unsun Cosmetics. This is a Black owned brand by a Black woman by the name of Katanya. So I'm actually really, really intrigued and excited to try this because this is supposed to be melanin friendly. We have two products here that both have SPF 30 broad spectrum. They both have a water resistance for 80 minutes. They're both physical sunscreens, so they're both gonna have that titanium and zinc oxide. So I'm gonna just demonstrate on one side how the texture feels and all that good jazz and see what it's giving on the skin, you know what I'm saying? So let's get into it, folks. Right here, as you can see, this is the color pigment that is coming out of the face sunscreen lotion, the lightweight matte protection. So let's go ahead and get into it. I'm gonna go ahead and gently rub it in, and now I'm just start pressing it into my skin. I do like the texture on how it feels. Get on this big old noggin. So that is the matte lightweight protection right here on this side. Most of mineral tinted sunscreens, they do give you a gray cast. This is giving me a bit of a gray cast. But what I will say is that this gray cast is not at the other level of some of the other gray purple casts that I have endured in my lifetime, like Banana Boat and everything else in between. So now we're on to the medium to dark. So this is medium to dark. In my opinion, I don't like when it's just only like light to medium and then medium to dark. What about like, you know, dark to deep? What about light or very deep? Because we forget about us, you know, chocolate people out here. And that's just going for all brands. Like, I really wish that there was a way that they could actually take the, get into that color wheel and really start formulating. Ooh, Jesus. yeah, start formulating deeper tones for deeper skin tones, because it is a bit of a missed market. Not a bit, it is a missed market that, you know, for us deeper complected individuals out there, we don't have something that is suitable for our skin. Some of us would like to wear, you know, a tinted sunscreen and be on about our day and going about our business. But I do like the actual consistency of them both. This has a bit more of a hydrating feel. It definitely is gonna give you more of that luminous look. So it does have a little bit more oils in there without it being too oily, which is good because I'm already combo to oily skin. So I just feel like this is like a good like little healthy glow. We're gonna go ahead and let this sit and marinate for 10 minutes and I'll be back and we gonna see what's popping. Be back, folks. All right, beautiful people, I am biggity back. As you can see, this is the medium to dark on this side. Yes, there is a gray cast. I let it warm up. It's not my shade, which, like I said, there really isn't a color meant for deeper skin complexion individuals like myself. But what you can do with either or of these, because this is the matte one, this also has a bit of a slight gray cast too as well. You could utilize these as like your primers if you think about it. Or even if you are like, you know what, I don't really want to use it as a primer. You can just literally use it as your SPF and then put a translucent powder on top of it or a pressed powder, whatever you like to use. Overall, I do happen to like the product on how the formulation is and how the texture is. It does not feel super greasy, nor does it feel super heavy, gritty. It doesn't feel like it's going to clog my pores or anything. Some sunscreens, I tend to get like a little bit of like an itchiness or some type of reaction. This one has not given me that, so that is awesome. Love that. But overall, I mean, I would definitely use these and I would incorporate a pressed powder or translucent powder or your concealer or foundation and put it on top. So, you know, you have your skin protected and you're making sure that you're keeping that skin cancer at bay. Okay. Because skin cancer is real and it does not discriminate.
So those are the sunscreens I'm really enjoying right now. Tell me in the comments below if you've tried any of them, if you're going to try any of them, or if you even have questions. You can find me on Instagram. I'm @SusanYara, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.